quite sure if you guys got the energy left or not, you know?
With the horns. Oh, yes. What the fuck?
Oh my god, really, really different sound from Ghost here, 20s, off the new album, Impera. Wow, man. So, good friend of mine, fellow Ghost lover, I was like, give me like three songs off of this new album that, you know, what you would deem maybe the best first take. Because I want to react to a couple songs off this album before I go listen to it myself. And this was one of the ones recommended. I think this is one of the songs, too, I've been seeing, you know, floating around the atmosphere of one of the good picks from this album. Right out of the gate, that horn, that big apocalyptic intro is delicious. That is so awesome. Heavy, heavy intro. Let me rewind it back really quick for a second to like 30 seconds in. Yeah. Dude, so fucking heavy. It's so funny to hear Ghost come from the band that they were on Opus, and very like Opus sounds very like hollow and like it's reverberating off of like a castle wall. Like every time I listen to early Ghost, like Opus into Infestissimum, to me it literally gives off such heavy medieval vibes, and that aesthetic has carried through all of their music, but like especially when we talk about the groundwork of their catalog. And then as they've moved on, where the big turning point I believe was Impera, with this really big, big studio sound, this heavy metal sound, it sounds like they've finally taken all of their inspirations, whoever they've looked up to in the past, maybe like very Sabbath-y, some Metallica, you know, trips in there, just like taking this big swath of like 70s cult, like black metal with a modern heavy metal sound that borders the campiness a little bit, done in a really classy, like consumable way. Like at no point listening to the cheesiness or the playfulness or the words and scenarios they're trying to convey in Tobias's lyrics does it come off as like off-putting or like this is too much for me. It's so streamlined in the whatever idea he has done for it. I say fuck all the haters. I think it's funny to call Ghost the Scooby-Doo band. You know, this is just metal Scooby-Doo music. You know, I guess you have to have an ear for it. You know, it's people are going to like everything. People are going to hate everything, you know, whatever. But let's get to this song. In my reactions, if you're here from the past or you're new here, I'm never really going to be that guy who delves into lyrical content or meanings behind songs unless it's so in my face apparent while I'm listening that I feel the need to comment on it, because for me as a listening experience, listening to new music is not about sitting and reading the lyrics on the first take. It's about getting everything in my head all at once as an initial like experience. Like I wouldn't have wanted to hear a song from the get-go and be kind of pinholed into whatever vision or meaning maybe the creator had for it from the get-go, because it robs me of letting it take the song wherever I might take it in my own head. You know, I love the thought of a song being created for this reason, but the listener taking it this direction, and then ultimately in the end, out of respect for the artist, over time gaining an understanding of what the song or the album meant and, you know, its residual. So I really stray away from like deep lyrical analyzation or reading lyrics during the thing. So I'm sorry if you feel I'm lacking on commenting on that front. But heavy intro, that horn section in the beginning was amazing. Very, very theatrical, very apocalyptic. Of the songs I've listened to so far on this album, this feels like the most theatrical, like almost like a curtain was brought up and they're giving you a Broadway play of Ghost the musical. You know, it seems stuck in a date, you know, more than I've heard past, you know, Ghost releases. It seems really focused. You know, I'm excited to see how well-rounded in maybe a singular theme this album truly is. There was a riff, I guess the continuous riff that was played throughout there. I made a note, the ba-ba-ba-da, ba-ba-ba-da, mixed with that really nice bass tone. It sounded so White Zombie. It made me think of Black Sunshine for a second. I don't know, you know, how I got there, but there was just a slight hint of that. Go back and listen to 20s and tell me if you don't hear some White Zombie undertones there. The bass I made a note of at like 150, you know, obviously it was carrying the whole song, but that was really apparent to me in that section. The bass is so freaking tasty, man. They've really beefed up the bass sound in, you know, this latter half of their catalog, and you know, there's nothing that breaks my heart more than a band by choice or by accidental mixing. The bass is so dissipated into the background that you can't hear it. You know, that's why I love bands like Tool. I'm on a Radiohead discovery. You know, big thick bass sounds. Metallica, my longest standing love of music ever, my favorite band of all time, I feel still to this day criminally underutilizes their bass, excluding, you know, their first three albums where it's almost as loud or louder than the guitar with Cliff. But go listen to Hardwired. Go listen to anything post Load Reload, because Load Reload actually had some really fat bass tones, you know, throughout those albums. But go listen to Death Magnetic, Hardwired. Rob is just so in the background, and to hear a flagship metal act that is single-handedly breaking their back carrying this fucking genre in 2022 with this huge bass tone, you know, something as simple as that is what can make a song for me. My favorite part of this whole song, the dynamic of it, was the drum and the bass syncopation was very gallopy, like riding into a forward motion, like it was like a groove. But the lyrics and the guitar shred solo there toward the end kept the pace feeling fast. So it was like you had this slow, heavy groove clashing with the increasing speed of the lyrics and the solo, and it made for a really great combination, kind of throwing you off, giving you a little vertigo, you know. Loved it. Great track. Relatively short, you know, but sweet, but is clearly probably going to play its part where it was, you know, sat in the album track list. So another great Ghost song. I'm so excited. Call Me Little Sunshine is not on this trailer, this channel, but it was on my Owen Jacobs channel before I decided to move all further reactions onto this channel. So the three songs I decided to react to on this new Ghost album are done. I'm going to go listen to that album finally once and for all by myself. So I had a great time. Thank you so much for watching. Please like and subscribe if you feel so inclined. I'm sorry you had to listen to me talk through sucking a breath mint or whatever. My throat's kind of sore right now, losing my voice a bit. But hey, I'm here. I'm excited to listen to new music. So happy to have you. I'll see you in the next one.